This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Dragon Masters, Book 6, Flight of the Moon Dragon, by Tracey West, read by Emily Ellett. This book is dedicated to all the Dragon Masters fans who write me letters and send me photos and pictures. You make me smile every day. TW. Before we start, while the Dragon Masters world is not the real world, many of the characters and places in it are inspired by real-world cultures. For this reason, I'll be pronouncing the names of these characters and places the way they'd be pronounced in the real world. These pronunciations may differ from how you think a name might sound based on its spelling alone. Chapter 1. Saving the Dragonstone.
"I am really worried about the Dragonstone," said Drake.
Six Dragon Masters sat around a dining table in King Roland's castle. Five of them lived in the castle: Drake, Beau, Rory, Anna, and Petra. Hiru, the sixth Dragon Master, lived in the Land of Pyramids. The Dragonstone had chosen each of them to connect with dragons. Hiru had flown a long way on Wadi, his dragon. Wadi was resting in the dragon caves. And Hiru had brought important news. The prime dragonstone was dying.
"You were right to be worried, Drake," said Hiru. "We must quickly find the prime stone so that we can try to save it. That is why I came here. My family thinks you and your friends can help us."
"Wait, what exactly is the prime dragonstone?" Beau asked.
Hiru looked down. A green stone hung from a cord around his neck. Each of the others wore a stone just like it.
"We each wear a piece of the Dragonstone to connect with our dragons," Hiru explained. "All of our smaller stones come from the Prime Stone."
"So is the Prime Stone huge?" asked Anna, who was also from the Land of Pyramids.
"I think so," said Hiru. "But I've never seen it. It has been kept inside a secret pyramid for many years. A scroll tells us that it will take six dragons to enter the pyramid. But first we must find it."
Just then, Griffith the wizard walked into the room.
"I have spoken with King Roland," he said. "I asked if you may all go to the Land of Pyramids. He will tell us soon. But I will stay here and look for a way to save the Dragonstone."
"The king has to say yes," said Rory. "If the Dragonstone dies, we won't be able to connect with our dragons anymore."
Petra, the newest Dragon Master, turned to Hiru.
"If you've never seen the Prime Stone, then how do you know it is dying?" she asked.
"Our family has a larger piece of the stone, just like Griffith does," Hiru explained. "Its glow keeps fading. And lately, I've had trouble connecting with Wadi. Those are signs that the Prime Stone is weakening."
As Hiru spoke, Drake's own dragonstone started to flicker. It wasn't glowing strong like it usually did when Worm, his earth dragon, communicated with him. But still, Drake heard his dragon's voice inside his head.
"Come," said Worm. "It is..."
Then his voice stopped.
"It's Worm," Drake said. "It sounds like something is wrong, but he didn't finish his message. We must go to the caves."
The Dragon Masters rushed down the long staircase that led to the dragon caves. Drake ran up to Worm, a brown dragon with tiny wings and a body like a snake.
"What's wrong?" Drake asked.
Worm nodded toward the cave of Vulcan, Rory's fire dragon. The dragon was snorting and pawing the ground.
"Vulcan!" Rory cried. She ran to him. "What's the matter?"
"His connection to you is getting weaker," Griffith explained. "Vulcan may be feeling confused and scared."
Rory reached through the bars of the cave and patted her dragon's nose.
Hang in there, Vulcan, she said. We'll find a way to save the Dragonstone.
Griffith?
Simon, a castle guard, said as he marched in.
King Roland agrees that the Dragon Masters should go to the Land of Pyramids. They may leave at once.
Chapter 2. The Dragon Temple.
Excellent, Griffith said. You are off to the Land of Pyramids.
My parents will be waiting for us when we arrive, said Hiru.
It sounds like a very long trip, said Petra. She twisted a blonde curl around her finger. Are we going to fly there?
No, we will have to use Worm's power to get us there quickly, explained Hiru.
Anna's dark eyes shone with excitement.
Worm can get us there in the blink of an eye, she said.
Can Worm take all of us and our dragons? Petra asked. Drake nodded. First, I'll tell him where to go. Then if everyone touches their...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.